new report from Axios indicates that, unfortunately, former Arizona GOP gubernatorial candidate Kari Lake is in fact getting ready for an October launch of her campaign for a Senate seat. Now, this is the Senate seat where the independent incumbent, independent is a kind word to use when describing Kyrsten Sinema, but that's the seat that Kyrsten Sinema currently holds. And so Lake had first teased the idea of a potential run while she was on the campaign trail with Ohio GOP Senate candidate Bernie Moreno. And that was just a few days ago, where she said, "I'm really, really excited about Senator J.D. Vance. I'm super excited that Bernie Moreno is going to be in the Senate. And if they're in the Senate, I just might have to join them." And then later, her senior advisor argued that having Kari Lake in Congress is really, really important to help Donald Trump after he wins the presidential election. I like the assumption there. Quote, "When President Trump gets back in the White House, he's going to need fighters like Kari Lake in Washington, D.C. to help enact his Agenda 47.
Dear God.
Kari Lake is seriously considering a run for the United States Senate and will be making a final decision this fall." So we should be concerned, because Kyrsten Sinema running as an independent essentially serves as a spoiler candidate. So if you're hoping that she loses, that Kari Lake loses, and that the Democrat challenging Sinema wins, it might be a little tougher, considering Lake has, I'm sorry, considering Sinema is running as an independent. So if Lake wins the GOP's primary next August, she likely will face off against the Democratic candidate here, Ruben Gallego, and the incumbent Kyrsten Sinema in the general election. So a potential three-way battle with Sinema running as the independent will expose deep divisions in both parties on whether to appeal to their bases or independents in a critical 2024 battleground state. So John, what are your thoughts on this so far?
I have many thoughts. I would largely file them under two different categories. So would you rather talk about Kari Lake as a candidate and her candidacy, or how this might shake out electorally?
Both.
Damn, okay. Let's start with electorally. So in terms of Kyrsten Sinema being a spoiler candidate, absent Kari Lake, the most recent polling, which I just went over this morning on the damage report, shows that she takes about three times as much support from the hypothetical Republican Lamb than she does from Ruben Gallego.
That's
she takes
true.
Like 8% of Gallego's support and like 22% of Lamb's support.
Okay, pause right there. I mean, it really tells you something that Kyrsten Sinema appeals so much to Republican voters in the state.
100%, yes. And so that basically takes a hypothetical two candidate race, which is dead tied, to one in which Gallego has like a 7-point lead.
Right.
So that's good. That can change, obviously, but that's what it looks like right now. So in theory, if it was a four candidate race with her running as some sort of independent MAGA candidate or something, well, then we're off to crazy town. I have no idea what happens. But if she takes out Lamb, which, why not? We live in hell. Why shouldn't she be the Republican candidate? Well, then how does that change the dynamic of who Sinema draws support from? She is drawing support from Republicans, probably relatively more independentish Republicans. And so one would think that Lamb, who is a comparatively sane person to Kari Lake, you replace him with Lake, then that is probably gonna turn off more Republicans, more of the more centristy Republicans.
Yep.
And then wouldn't they just go to Sinema at that point?
Mm-hmm.
Like, I don't know for sure, and I haven't seen the polling, but I would imagine that the effect that we're already seeing, at least in this most recent, I think it was Emerson that did the poll, would probably be amplified with Kari Lake.
Let's take a look at the Emerson poll, in fact. It's graphic four here. So according to that poll, voters were presented with a potential list of candidates for the 2024 Republican US Senate primary. 42% support former gubernatorial candidate Kari Lake. 11% support Sheriff Mark Lamb. That's not good. 7% support former Senate candidate Blake Masters. 2% support Brian Wright. And then 28% of them are undecided.
I mean, there's going to be a significant percentage that are turned off by her last run.
I hope
they're
so.
They're gonna see her as a likely loser because she lost a race that the Republicans had no business losing, and she's terrible. And also, you're gonna have the drag of Donald Trump, who she has very closely tied herself to. So to whatever extent Trump is turning off voters, she's gonna get as much of the effect of that out of maybe any state level candidate.
Right. You know, I was curious if this was a play, not necessarily because she actually wants to win the Senate seat, but because she wants to just be in the public's radar.
It's possible.
Hoping that, you know, Trump, you know, chooses her or taps her as, you know, his VP pick. I mean, that's been the big rumor for a long time now. I don't know, that could be part of this. All I know is cinema is freaking awful, just absolutely awful. I want to just quickly go back to what John was saying earlier about how cinema is actually pulling in a lot of support from Republican voters. Just for those who might have missed the backstory on that, cinema ran as a progressive Democrat. Okay, someone who actually cared about climate change, who wanted to reject corporate interests and corporate money. She did the exact opposite. And so she got so much pushback from Democratic voters for helping to defeat and water down Biden's economic agenda that she decided to switch parties. She went from being a self-identified Democrat to then saying that she's no longer a Democrat, but rather an independent. So with that information in mind, let's go to graphic six. About 21% of Republicans would vote for Sinema with Mark Lamb on the ballot. Remember, Mark Lamb is the other Republican. And 34% of Republicans would support Sinema with Brian Wright on the ballot. By contrast, Sinema only pulls about 8% of Democratic support from Gallego. And that makes sense. Gallego is actually a Democrat, so I can understand why most Democratic voters in the state would rather support him as opposed to Sinema.
Exactly.
So
yeah.
Anyway, it's gonna be a circus. Looking forward to it. We'll see how it plays out.
Yeah.
Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.